So welcome to the philosophy class Introduction to Ethics and Philosophy of Science, The Microscope and the Elephant. Of course, you will have to do assignments. I will now give you an overview of the assignments for this course and some explanation with it. There are a lot of assignments actually. There are 9 assignments and we go over them. You have to write 3 columns, 2 exams, 1 essay, 1 video essay, 1 coloring picture, not kidding, which is also really a competition where you can win book vouchers, and 1 presentation. So columns. Actually, it's an academic column, so it's a column which has some specific requirements, and we will go over that. First of all, everything that you hand in, all the assignments, all the written assignments, have to be peer-reviewed by a fellow student, preferably a student from who also takes this course, because then this student can look at, knows what the requirements are. Please take this peer reviewing seriously. Peer reviewing is also a very important academic skill. And of course it's important that you look at some other students' work, and you can be nice, you can say, well, of course this is nice, and make a compliment, but then also really check if it meets the criteria and the requirements. So also be strict and not just say, okay, this is very nice and good. Also, so really put some effort in it. And use the feed-forward form, but we see it later. It's also in the book, The Microscope and the Elephant, which really has a list with all the requirements. In order to make sure you can improve your skills on writing, you get a lot of feedback. And actually, that's why we have so many assignments, so that you have feedback, look at the feedback, go to the next assignment, look at the feedback, go to the next assignment, and then you improve. So that hopefully you have a learning curve here. You get different kind of feedback. One of them is individual feedback. On each column, you get individual feedback from one of the team members of Team Microscope. That's one. And you will get collective feedback. With collective feedback, I mean, I look at all the feedback, and then I look at your assignment and think about what are the points which really can help you improve. So you get collective feedback both on the content and on the writing skills. So a lot of feedback, but always keep on looking backwards to the feed-forward form to make sure that it really meets the requirements. Also, I have recorded a video clip on how to write an academic column. Also, please look at that video. So, these are the important requirements. Make one well-argued point. One well-argued point. We look at the structure. That should be a clear structure with one clear message. You should use philosophical argumentation. Make use of the mandatory reading. You apply critical thinking. It should be a clear writing style. Sometimes students come to me and said, yes, sir, but I mean this. And I said, yeah, but why didn't you write it down what you mean? You should write down what you mean. You do some research, and the reference should be in APA. That's the Association, American Psychological Association. If you don't know what it is, Google it, and it takes you 10 minutes and then you know what it is. So what I mean with an academic column is that it has strict requirements. It is just as rigorous as a peer-reviewed paper, but now it is accessible for general audience. Okay, so you can see, so you use the feedback form, the number of words are about 500 and 550 words maximum. Check the spelling and grammar check, really students do it, and make sure the English is correct. And if you know your English is not so good, make sure that you have someone check it who is good in English. I know maybe some of the students might be having trouble in writing. Maybe you even are dyslexic. That's fine. But if then don't let it refute door someone who is also dyslexic, right? So know your own weaknesses and know how to overcome that. Yeah. So you are responsible for your own work and make sure that the English and the grammar is correct. And if you need help, well, you make sure that you get that help. Write the name of the reviewer on the column. And the references, there should be at least one logical reference to the accompanying literature, because that's one way to make a connection between the literature and your assignment. That's a little bit, of course, formalized, but that is meant that you use the theory, because this is a philosophy class and you should use philosophical theory. Yeah? And you can submit it via Blackboard. Actually, here we have the English critics, Matthew Arnold. And actually, he wrote it what I have in mind. Have something to say, so make one clear point, and say it as clearly as you can. That is the secret of style. So pay attention to style. The essay, what I mean with an essay is that's a little bit bigger column. And an essay, the pioneer of essay writing is this philosopher, Michel de Montaigne, in the 16th century, French philosopher. And an essay, he made a point in his essays, but it was like searching for answers, but also about himself. So it can be personal. So our essays are academic essays, so not so much literary essays as Michel de Montaigne, but the genre is from Michel de Montaigne, but his essays are really worthwhile to read, and he has a lot of interesting quotes like this. Good marriage would be between a blind wife and a deaf husband. So that's something to reflect upon. Here we have the feed forward form. I don't go over it. But make sure that you check all this and use it in your column. So really have a close look at it. One of the things are before it says, don't put a full stop in the title. And still students do it. So apparently they didn't read it. So make sure you really check this. And also if you had a reviewer, check it. Check if it meets all the requirements. Not difficult, but it is some work. A whole different assignment is the group assignment. And the assignment is that you in groups of 5 to 6 students, and they are randomly created, these groups, that you make a video, maximum 4 minutes. And in this video, you make one clear normative point on ethics. And let me tell you in advance, so this is about trying, remember Bloom's taxonomy, that you are really creative. But and of course I know that editing is not a skill that we learn here, but today's, how the media works, it seems much more important to have videos than writing. So I think it's important that you can apply philosophy, not only in writing, but also in videos. So in small groups, you make this assignment. And people, you might end up with people whom you not really like. But working together with people who are not your friends is a really important skill in life. And that's, if you work later in a company or wherever you're gonna work, you will work in teams and they are probably not always your friends. And it's very good that you train yourself to work together to the best of your efforts, even if you don't have to be friends with everyone. So just do it. Huh? So you learn an important skill working together. And I know that some of you are better in editing than others. So the thing is, if you have a 4-minute video and it has one clear normative point and it has some theory in it, then the grade is automatically an 8. So, and it's only 10% of the total grade, so this is actually more like a bonus. You can really make, well, maybe improve your general grade a little bit by this. So, but this is a, this has a huge learning opportunity, and the outcome is, we have seen some excellent movies videos, and we will put all the videos together in the gallery, and we use pitch to peer. I will explain more about that in class. Then we have the coloring picture. Again, I hope that this philosophy class helps you to think out of the box. And also one of the things is that maybe writing is not the only form to be creative and to be critical. So this is an opportunity to be creative and critical in a different way. This is this is the poster, and this is a poster about the differences in left and right in American politics. So this coloring picture is about political philosophy, and it has, when you first read the book on political philosophy and then you see this poster, then you will understand more about this poster. You don't have to agree with the poster, but in order to make you reflect on the poster, we use it as a coloring picture. So you have to hand it in, doesn't matter how, it doesn't have to look nice, but you have to hand it in order to pass this course. And then my two sons, they will be the judges, and they will have four prizes for the most beautiful, most original of these assignments, and you'll get a book voucher if you are winning. Probably this example is not very original and probably won't have won, but that you will notice that. Okay, so if you can really make as much of this as you want, and if it's an opportunity for you to be creative, to think out of the box, to use different skills, but you're not required to do it. Well, you are required to do it, but you're not required to be really creative. So these are the topics. So we have of the columns. These are different colors because they're different topics. The first two are on philosophy of science, and these are on ethics. The first column actually is what should be in the academic column, a canon, what every student should know and why. In a moment I will go deeper into that, so but that's the topic of column one. Column two is to write about one specific pseudoscience and to apply philosophy of science and write why it's not scientific. For example, why is homeopathy not scientific? That's one clear example. The third column is about a case study, so a very clear case, usually from the media, about the humans, non-human animal relationship, animal ethics. And then the essay is a case study on the human environment relation, so environmental ethics. The video assignment is a case study on ethics, so it can be animal ethics, political philosophy, applied ethics, can be anything, as long as it is a very clear case study on ethics.